Spider-Man, trying to run, reading comics, toys are hella sick, Stardom.
But yep, that's happened. Hey, what's up, you guys? Shardimus Prime here, doing another Marvel Legends action figure review on the Marvel Legends Professor X with hover chair. If you're to pick this up, you can do so at
big. Get your big badass toys at bigbadtoystore.com. Click the link in the description below.
Very nice packaging right here. I like the X-Men. I may cut this out afterwards and put it on my X-Men shelf. I don't know. Got a little bit of a scratch right there. But anyway, on the side, you can see Professor X. On the back, you can see some product shots. There's Deadpool over there. There's a read-up over here. If you want to read it, go ahead and pause it right now. Then on this side, you get Professor X again. We get an X logo at the very top. Not much more at the bottom, so let's get to it and crack this thing open. And here's Professor X out of the packaging and out of his chair and on the floor asking for help. I always thought that was fascinating when Professor X would fall. I mean, he's such a powerful character, but then, you know, his legs don't work. But anyway, this is a great looking figure, and I am extremely excited to have the hover chair, which I'll show off in just a little bit. But first, let's take a closer look at Professor X. I lied. I first wanted to go over the Farouk, aka Shadow King, head sculpt, and to briefly go over the bio of this X-Men villain character. He's an ancient Egyptian mutant with immortality, and he has telepathic abilities as well as possession abilities. And I think it's fairly obvious what Hasbro used for the source material when creating this head sculpt, and I love that they gave us this. I did plop it on the Kingpin Build-A-Figure body already, and now I want a second Kingpin Build-A-Figure. Oh man, it looks so great. I love how the teeth came out right over here. We get that metallic green for the glasses right there. The beady red eyes look really good. I love the detail right here with the black paint mixed in right there and some of the creases. I guess we could have used a little bit more of that black paint here and there. And then this came off around the side right here. One thing to warn you about is when plopping it on and taking it off the Kingpin body, yeah, you do want to be careful. You don't want to, you know, have your thumb bump into these glasses or apply any kind of force or friction against the glasses right there. But yeah, looking at the top right over there, there's a little, I don't know the name of the hat, but yeah, I'm going to just call it a hat with a tassel. And I did add the Monster Venom Build-A-Figure claws to the figure. Totally ripped this idea off from X-Men 87. I think it was actually quite brilliant, so that works out really well. So if anyone has any extra Monster Venom Build-A-Figure arms that they don't need, I'll buy them off you. You know, that looks pretty sick, man. So I'm pretty stoked that you can do that. That is awesome. So now we have a whole other character for our Marvel Legends collection. I love it. And here's a look at the Professor X head sculpt. I think this is a perfect head sculpt for a comic version Professor X figure. He has those mean eyebrows. He's got that big old head, and yeah, he's a cue ball. Yeah, he's baldy, and it looks like Professor X to me. It looks like a classic Professor X. By the way, of which, old school Professor X did some messed up stuff, right? Like, if you guys read the older X-Men comics, I remember him, like, starting a false love triangle between Angel, Cyclops, and Jean Grey. Didn't he implant some ideas in Jean's head, or was it an Angel's head? I can't remember. Remind me in the comments section below, but I do remember there definitely at least being one case of him kind of doing some weird, shady, messed up stuff, like, with the X-Men teenagers' minds, you know, kind of a creepy guy in the old days, but you know, I guess the character's been, you know, not so bad in recent history. Do have a complaint about some of the other accessories. We do get the Cerebro head sculpt, right, or helmet right there. Is it Cerebra? I always get the Cerebra and Cerebro confused, but you get the helmet, and it looks great. We have this little bit of a hint of teal in that gunmetal gray color, and I like that. It looks very cool, so that's pretty sweet, and you can just plop it on the head. And see, it's, I feel like I'm going to scuff that head sculpt every time, but it's not really so bad. I'd used this several times already. You didn't see a ton of scuffs on that head sculpt anyway. So that looks pretty cool. You know, got it right over the nose so you could see the eyes. That's pretty sweet. And then we have this effect piece right here coming straight from the vast deference and out of the back of the head of Professor X. You could just port that in right there and... wow. Okay, so they could have used any other color but this. I mean, I just think this is a bad choice. And it looks better with the adjusted lighting and the black backdrop. But yeah, we get a pearlescent sheen to it. And I've seen this before. I could not find a comic panel that had this kind of look, but I remember seeing it before. And I think they could have gone with any other color. I think they could have used pink. I think pink would have actually worked out better. But you can see in a couple of images right over here. It was actually tricky, you know, for me to find panels. You know what I mean? I had to go through my trade collection and, you know, actually take photos from my trades. But yeah, so I think that was a poor choice as far as the color goes, even though I think I have seen it before in the comics. I do like the texturing of the sculpt, so that's pretty cool. I just wish that they'd gone with a different color anyway. Yellow would have been fine, or pink. I would have preferred pink. That way you could put it on Jean Grey or somebody else. I thought that would have been cool, but yeah. Then here's looking at the back of it. you know, so it's not sculpted and painted too bad. It's just, yeah, the color choice just throws me off. And getting that off right there and looking at the rest of the figure, I mean, we've seen this chameleon body mold several times before in the past. So he has a green suit and a black and blue striped tie, and he does have some new hands attached to him. On the left hand, you get this wide open hand, which I think works really well. On the right side, you get the Moyer McTaggart pleasure pose, looking pretty good, you know, nice detail in the fingers and everything. Then we get the green pants, silver buckle right there, black belt, looking pretty good, nice brown shoes. So yeah, I like it. He still has the peckles underneath his feet, which are pretty weak, and then there's the back of the figure. And then here's a look at the hover chair, which arrives in 5 different pieces, and this is not technically Baff art, but I accepted the challenge. Doesn't look too bad, But anyway, I want to get a closer look at this effect piece right here before we put the hover chair together, because this just looks so great. I really like the clear plastic that we're seeing, and we get some painted white around the edges. So very cool looking effect piece. I think they did a great job with this. I don't know if I'm going to have the hover chair sitting on this the whole time, just because it sits kind of high and it may be blocking a lot of other characters that I have on the X-Men shelf, but I really love this piece. But putting it aside right over here for right now, let's get the rest of this thing built while you take away Bumblebee. All right, so let's go ahead and start with one half. What I recommend doing is you just take one side of it and then you add the butt cushion, and we're going to go ahead and plop that into the port right over here, and then we're going to take this piece and slide that in. You can see that there's this little groove right here, so we want to have that piece go right through the groove. And then now we have one half of it, and then we can just port this all together, make sure that the backrest is not, you know, running into anything, and there we go. So we have a hover chair, and you can go ahead and port it onto this guy right here if you'd like, or you can just have it rest like that. Either way, works out really well. Now, it does irk me that you can clearly see a bunch of marbling in the plastic right over here, so that's a little gripe number one. Gripe number two is that I keep getting gabbage right here in the very back, and I don't know how to, you know, stop that from happening. It doesn't bother me too much, because when I push together more so right here, it doesn't split the front or anything, and the front looks a lot better than the back side. You can see that we have some nice sculpted and details throughout on this. I really like the vents at the bottom right here. That looks great. I think this is really awesome looking. I'm so happy to have this thing. I've been just holding off on gushing throughout this whole video, but man, we've been wanting this for such a long time. And we thought that we were going to get one from Toy Biz at one point. I think they had started designing one, but they just never did it. You know, it was going to be a Build-A-Figure or Build-A-Vehicle thing. I know they're going to do it for the Quinjet, and I remember them talking about doing it for this hover chair. And yeah, the cushion looks really good in there. The back piece looks good. It has this very dark navy blue color to it. And then you have these panels, which I love that they did this. You just slide that out, and then you can see that little screen right there and the console and all these buttons and everything. On his left side, you could lift this up and you could see this keyboard with the red button. I guess this is for the danger room. That's what I'm expecting it to be for, or suspect it to be for. But yeah, looking on the side right here, some more sculpted details and everything, man. This just looks great. I'm very happy with this. And then we actually get one other piece that's not technically part of the hover chair, but, you know, it kind of is. We get the blanket right there. You know, you gotta have your paralysis blanket. So that looks really cool. And we have Professor X ready to go, and you can just plop him right inside right here, and you want to get the arms out of the way. Now, I found myself not really paying attention to which side goes in first with this thing. I don't know. This lip piece, I don't know, tends to go first for me anyway, so you can do that if you want, and it works out just fine. Doesn't look bad at all, but if you'd like, maybe put it in the other way, and that works out well too. So either way, it works. You know, I don't think there's a wrong way to put that blanket on his legs, but man, this is so sick having this thing. We are truly in a golden age of Marvel Legends right now. This is just too sick. So pleased. I'm not going to be thorough with the articulation on Professor X, because it's the same articulation as a chameleon figure, but the head does look all the way up, and both wrist hinges move up and down. And to measure out the Professor X figure, you can see he's just over 6 inches tall. To measure out the hover chair, though, that's just a little under 6.5 inches tall. And then I'm seeing about just shy of 6 inches across. And throwing Chuck back into the hover chair and measuring this hover chair without the effect, you can see it's standing closer to about 5.5 inches tall. So pretty sweet. He's not going to block too many characters on the shelf. And then here's Professor X with his hover chair compared to Shadow King. And then for your Marvel Legends Professor X comparison, we have the Hasbro version next to the Toy Biz version right here, which reused the movie Professor X chair without the function. And man, I really love this figure for quite some time, and this one's totally gonna take its place now. Gotta say, I'm amazed at how well Hasbro's been able to kind of slowly but surely eliminate Toy Biz figures from my shelves. But yeah, this looks really good still. I still like this figure, and if you wanted to switch these two, yeah, you could totally do that. That works pretty well if you want to make that happen. You know, in the older X-Men books, he did not have this hover chair. He had a regular wheelchair more like this. It didn't have the X symbol right there in the wheel, but yeah, you know, if you wanted to do that, you could. He still needs his blanket though, and that's not really working out that great because it's supposed to cover his legs entirely. Then for a hover chair comparison, we have the hover chair from the Toy Biz Professor X, and there's no Professor X because I was so desperate to have a hover chair that I actually had taken the figure out right over here. As you can see, it's kind of broken now, but yeah, thank you, Ice Cat. Anyway, but yeah, this has the whole console thing that you could open up inside. You can see a whole bunch of details in there. You know, this wasn't too bad, you know, but yeah, you can see the similarities, you can see the differences. And then here's Professor X next to his casemate. We have Deadpool with his scooter, and I mentioned in my review of this guy that I had a hard time getting his butt sitting right here, and he does make contact. It's just that the way that they sculpted this seat, there's a point right over there, and the only way I can get him sitting on it is like if his taint lines up right with that point, and it's just really awkward and weird getting him sitting on it, but it doesn't look bad by any means. But yeah, for a size comparison, you can see the two of them right there. Pretty sweet. Then here's Professor X next to a couple Magneto figures. I could not find my Toy Biz Series 3 Magneto, huh? But anyway, we have the amazing Yamaguchi Magneto and the recently released Hasbro Magneto. I cannot wait for the new Magneto from the 3-pack. And then here's Professor X next to his bro. We got the Build-A-Figure Juggernaut. And then here's Professor X next to a couple of X-Men. We have the Jim Lee Cyclops, and we have the Jim Lee Jean Grey right there, and I did add that effect to the back of her head, and that's still not really working. I really wish they went with a light pink color. That would have worked out so much better. And then here's Professor X next to your average 6-inch scale figure. We have the Marvel Legends Big Time Classic Spider-Man. Yeah, so you can read minds, huh? Do you know what I'm thinking right now, huh? Huh? Can you guess? Can you guess? Whoa, what's up with my hand?
Oh, why did I have it set to split?
So I had a great time with this figure, man. I absolutely love it. Hasbro totally delivered on this piece. I don't see anything really wrong with it aside from that whole effect thing, which I'm not sure if anyone's a huge fan of that, but that itself is not even awful. So I love this piece. I do highly recommend it. And at the price of about $40, I'm giving this a sub rating of...
I love it!
And I'd like to know what you guys think. So please let me know in the comment section below. Will you have it posed like this? Will you add the accessories and whatnot? I'm gonna have mine displayed just like you're seeing it right here. So I'm very happy with this figure. If you want to see some photos, you can find them all over at marvelousnews.com. I took a whole bunch of shots. And if you want to follow me on social media, you can check me out on Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, and Stardust. Links to everything in the description below. I'll catch you guys later. Yeah. Peace.
Oh, my bad.
Posing action figures. I'm posing action figures. I'm posing action figures every day. It's okay.
That's crispy.
Hey, I'm Sharpness Prime videos. Hey, you should click one. Yeah, click on one of them. Or subscribe if you haven't. We're shot.